Welcome back. Hope you've had a great week. Let's get this party started with a few announcements. These SJHS shirts and hoodies have arrived. If you have ordered one from Mrs. Van, Mrs. Rowe, or an avid student, please stop by 4212 to pick up your item. The next driver's ed class will begin November 4th. There is a required parent-student meeting on October 31st at 6:30 in the auditorium. Going green! Anyone needing recycling picked up from their classrooms, call 1142 during second block. For those of you that are not tree huggers, that means paper and or bottles. Are you doing online credit recovery courses? Do you need to make up time due to absences and or tardies? If so, Evening Academy is the place for you! We are open Monday through Thursday after school from 2:30 to 4:30 and 4216.
20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do rather than the ones you did do. I'm Katie Barber, and that was your weekly words of wisdom.
Here's this week's Twitter picture of the week. Thanks to Carson Denny for posting. Don't forget to tweet pictures to @SJHSOracleNews with the hashtag Word of the South. And you may see your picture here next week. This week's Faculty Spotlight is Miss Ashley Lane. Let's head over to her classroom.
My name's Ashley Lane. I went to UNC Chapel Hill. I graduated in 2011 and I majored in Media Studies and Production, so basically film studies, and I minored in Italian, which is what I teach here. What I like about South Johnston is the feeling of community and family among the teachers, and also the overall spirit of positive learning from the students. In teaching Italian at South Johnston, I hope to be able to show students that the skills required to learn a language can be spread out over many subjects. That way, they can use those skills for every class that they have at South Johnston. A fun fact about me would probably be that I'm a book hoarder. I have about 400 books in my room right now, and it's a problem.
Now, for two additional teacher spotlights. The first goes to the new teacher of the month, as recognized by staff.
Wisconsin is his home, and cheese curds his favorite snackers. And let's not forget how he loves those Packers.
And though he loves football, no matter what quarter, school always comes first, because his priorities are in order. Congratulations, Derek Mickey.
Thank you.
Congrats to Mr. Mickey. Now we're headed over to Mr. Price live for a special award.
We are about to make Mr. Rowland's year. He has never won an award. And this year, he is the Pepto-Bismol PDP of the Year Award. Follow me.
Progress here, if there's any, in Mr. Rowland's room, to present for the first time ever an award to Mr. Rowland that will air on the news next week, I believe.
It's about time.
It is about time.
15 years I've been doing this job.
He has earned an award. This is not made up. This is a real award, he has earned. This year, he put together the best professional development plan of any teacher.
Thank you.
A PDP, which is showing a teacher's growth. And it is sponsored by Pepto-Bismol. And if you notice, it is a picture. We call him with a wig on. So this is the PDP. Yeah, I'm sorry. But this is the PDP of the Year Award presented to Chris Rowland.
Like I said, it's been 15 years in the way.
Okay, so he doesn't have to make a speech or anything. Thank you very much, and go back to teaching. Thank you.
Thank you.
Congrats, Mr. Rowland, for a job well done. Last weekend, many of our students and faculty participated in Meal Days. Here's a few highlights of the festivities.
Southern Alabama with the guitars jamming, that's where we're hit. Straight up to Butte and Montana singing, Lord, I was born a rambling man. California to Oregon, even New York.
Our scouts have been on the lookout, searching high and low for this week's talent. Let's go live to see who they found.
That's good.
For tennis this week, Elizabeth Stricken won the singles match, and Brianna Williams and Carly Parker won the doubles match on Monday against Cleveland. The conference tournament will be next Monday and Tuesday. Make us proud.
Soccer defeated Western Hornet Monday night 2-0.
The Pink Eye game will be on October 18th. See an SGA member in the comments during power to purchase a shirt. They're only $12.
Golf placed fourth in a conference match Monday with a 156. Congratulations to Sydney Wheelis, Emily Kirsch, Rachel Wheeler for having the three best scores.
The golf team is raffling off cornhole boards again this year. Tickets are $5 each or three for $10. Winner will be announced during halftime on November 8th. Please see Coach Benson or a golf team member to purchase a ticket.
Basketball tryouts will be October 30th. You must have a current physical tryout. See David Dew, Brody Massengill, or Keith Summer with questions. More information to follow.
And now over to Krista with the Player of the Week.
I'm Krista Collins, and I'm here with your Player of the Week.
I'm Shawnee Ketchum, your Player of the Week. I'm a senior. I play volleyball, swim, and do track.
Back to you, Veronica and Flossie.
We are in the process of gathering information for all of the clubs here at South, so you can choose where to get involved. Teachers are reminded to complete the form ASAP. The Save a Life Club will host a guest speaker on Monday during Power A and B in the auditorium to talk about teen suicide prevention. Everyone is welcome. If you purchased a Keep Calm and Carry On t-shirt, please wear it on Monday to show your support. Keep Calm shirts will be on sale during Power next week, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Once again, it's time to head to the halls to find out why South is the best school in the county.
It's Power. Cheerleading, football, all the sports, volleyball, that's it.
And it's Power Lunch and Fries.
Power Block.
TAing in Heart with Brittany.
Guadalupe, the girls, and the football team.
This concludes this week's Word of the South. A review, Mr. Price.
Hey, we're going to need you back here Monday safely. So leave that dun-da-dun at home. Deuces. I'm out of here.